the answer. It's not the answer.
Okay.
It's not the answer. Calm down. All right. Let's get to that, sir.
Sir, I'd like to press charges, please. Press the charges.
Just got your citizenship.
Until they get back.
The officers linger for a few tension-filled moments, then continue on their way. Rollerson hangs in the tree, paralyzed with fear.
Do I get down and try to make a move? Is there more coming? You know, you kind of confused. You don't know what to do. Because, what am I going to do? It was stressful.
Get away. Speed was very elusive.
Pussy's family all live in Inglis. But he needs to leave Florida until things cool down.
Of course, I wasn't just going to sit there and get arrested, so I got away.
Rollerson sees an ad in the paper for work in Alaska. He jumps at the opportunity.
So I decide I'm going to go fishing.
Rollerson takes some of the bank robbery money and buys a one-way ticket to Alaska. Within days, the wanted man is settling into a new life in Homer, Alaska, not far from Anchorage.
The housekeeper ain't been here for a while, huh? What did I for you? I gave you $1,500.
He uses some of his unstained cash to buy a small trailer in the woods.
Appreciate it, Paul.
He takes the alias Bruce Clear, using an old ID from a friend.
Yeah, he tells him for crab. Sure enough. Starts this week.
He finds work as a deckhand on a crab fishing boat.
All right. Appreciate it. Let's walk.
It's one of the most dangerous jobs in the world.
It was 40, 50, 60 foot seas. I mean, it was some bad weather that year. Windshield factor got to 102 below zero. It was good work. It didn't make a man out of me, and I loved it.
It's been a month since Robinson robbed the bank in Florida. Authorities in his hometown continue to question the fugitive's friends and family.
I ain't seen him in a long time.
This is what the cop told me, okay? He said, "We don't care what you're doing. We want Speedy Rollers. I'm on his friend list, okay? I want to stay there."
Yeah, they haven't given paid the loaner, but I wouldn't do something like that.
And I'm not going to leave the cops to it.
The case quickly goes cold.
Speedy was gone. You know, he's done. He's hit the big time now. He's rolling in higher mountains.
Local authorities alert the Florida Department of Law Enforcement. Special Agent Jim Flournoy begins an investigation.
It was such a cat and mouse game with him, and we knew we were up against the wall. Not only was he a violent guy, not only was he good in the woods, you know, again, he had people we knew that were helping him, and we continued to stay a step behind him.
This is Special Agent Jim Flournoy, Florida Department of Law.
Agent Flournoy coordinates with the U.S. Marshals in case Rollerson has left the state.
Yes, sir. He should be staying. I really recognize that.
If you hear anything else, you let me know.
Law enforcement around the country are now on the lookout for the red dye-stained money. Rollerson is returning to his trailer after work when he gets a disturbing surprise.
Out of the blue, the Homer Police Department kind of pulled right up to my trailer. Two cops got out in bulletproof vests and walked right up to me. And I turned around and I look at them and they said, "So, you robbed any banks in Florida lately?"
"Oh, sir, I sure haven't. What y'all talking about?"
The two officers have been cornered right outside his front door.
"My name's Bruce Slater, and my dancer ain't robbed no banks.
I'm trying to figure out how in the world they know who I am and you know, that I robbed the bank."
"Yes, sir, that's why you're with the city.
We need to show that you had a duffel bag full of money."
"My duffel bag full of money? I won't be out fishing crab now."
Dye-stained money has turned up in Homer, Alaska. The police ask Rollerson for permission to search his trailer.
"Take a look at it?" "No, you all can take a look if you want.